Are you an Indian student who has just received their visa and ready to fly abroad, but unsure what to pack and not to leave those essential behind? Well, you're at the right place. Bonjour, welcome back to India to France. So we are going to Pont Sepeir and it is hardly 1 kilometer away from my place. So recently I have taken subscription of Vélo Toulouse, which is 20 euros per year. And what you can do is take this cycle, ride it for 30 minutes and dock it to the next station within 30 minutes. So it's completely free and you can do it as many number of times as you want in a day. But in case if you exceed 30 minutes, that's gonna charge you 50 cents per another 30 minutes. Let me show you how to undock it. So first I open Vélo Toulouse and I select which cycle that I want to ride. So now it's number 8. I have 60 cents. There goes my pastel card. Yeah, there we go. And the timer has begun. Side over it now. Yoppa, side over it now, yoppa. This is how we dock it. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Ramya, a 31-year-old former engineer turned marketeer, currently pursuing my master's degree in marketing, that is in Toulouse, France. I traded my desk job to backpack and chase my dreams in France. So if you are here for the same journey, then you are at the right place. Now let's begin with all the documents that are necessary for you to bring here. Firstly, passport and flight tickets, of course, so have it a physical copy of it. Next is all your university documents such as acceptance letter, enrollment proof, proof of funds, and any other certificates that's been given by your uni. Next, the birth apostille certificate, and also have it translated. It is very much necessary for your social security, which you are going to do once you are here in next 2 to 3 months. Medical prescription, if you are carrying any medications. Debit card, I do not suggest you to bring any Forex card, which I'm going to talk about later, but you do have to get your debit card or any credit card that you use in India and which also has a access in other countries as well. Accommodation certificates or the contract which has been provided by your landowner or the agency such as Studapart. Accommodation host contact details. This is very much necessary because once you land here, you might be cut off of all the communication that you might have. So it's better to have the address along with the host details just in case of emergencies. Some are optional such as passport size photos, which we carried 8 per person, which we thought we might use it in later stages, but until now we have not used, so it's optional completely. Next is one government issued ID card such as your Aadhaar card, which comes in PVC material. That is something which you can carry around until you do your validation here. Now, the second one. Let's jump to travel essentials. First is the minimum cash, and don't carry too much because it's not really necessary. We carried a lot of cash, which eventually we used it, but then I do not recommend carrying so much cash. So converting 10,000 rupees to euros, I think that should last, because that's what some of my friends did. And yeah, don't carry more than 20,000-30,000 per person. Next is luggage tags and locks. These are extremely important, because once you are here, you will be traveling to other Schengen countries, right? So it's better if you have the tags so that you don't get your luggage lost somewhere. And also the locks, because here it's a little expensive, so you might want to carry at least one from your home country. Adapters and extension cords of various electronic devices. Adapters, definitely two at least. If you're carrying more, then good for you, which are universal adapter or something which is used in Europe, and the one that you need. So not just two, please try to carry more. If you carry one extension cord along with this, well and good. But if you're multiple people, like friends have come along, something like that, then two extension cord is a must. Backpack and tote bags, it's always handy to carry some extra. Cleaning supplies for initial days, such as laundry detergent, bars, utensil washing bars. So these are very much important. First aid kit, guys, because once you land here, you might be converting rupees into euros, and then you might be feeling overwhelmed to buy anything in any store. So better get a first aid kit along with some nail grooming kit. If you often tend to bite your nails, you might wanna take care of your nails. Fevikwik and Fevicol, this is something which we don't get here, but there might be some alternative, but so far I have not discovered anything. So I am in need of a Fevikwik. Suppose if you're coming, please do carry an extra Fevikwik for me. Next, the medicine and the prescription. So medicine, it could be something for basics such as headache, nausea, constipation, body ache, vitamin C, diarrhea, sore throat and cold. So these are the medications that you should be carrying with you, and also have a prescription for these. Now let's go to clothing. So definitely carry warm clothes with you, such as thermals, coat, sweater, scarf and gloves. So these are a must have, at least one pair each of those. Next is casual clothes for everyday wear. So there is one myth I definitely want to address here, guys, is that every other cold country, you often see other content creators talking about carrying black dresses, but that doesn't hold good here, right? So you might want to carry some black dresses for those winter days, but then definitely carry your colorful dresses. So as you can see in my background, people usually take out their most bright colorful clothes out during summers, and summer lasts here for at least 2-2.5 months. So you might not want to show yourself in top to bottom black dress, which is boring. So make sure you carry a well-balanced clothes for your casual days. Next, at least one pair of formal clothes, which is necessary. If there are any events at your university, then comfortable shoes, at least two pair. I would suggest you have more than two, one for your running, if you're exercising something, one for casual and one formal. However, my recommendation would be that you buy all of these from there, because buying shoes here is extremely expensive. That's what we did, because we had bought only two to three pairs around to France, but then after coming here, all of them got worn out, so we had to buy new pairs, and it's extremely expensive. For example, one of Rahul's pair costed us 60 euros. So that might come around 5,500-ish, and 5,500 rupees. And with this money, I think you might have got much better branded shoes. So look out for that. So that's about the shoes. Next, you might want to carry one raincoat and definitely one umbrella at least, and a back cover, because during the rainy season, the rain along with the wind is going to create chaos. So you might don't want to be drenched in water along with your backpack. So do carry raincoat, umbrella and a cover, bag cover. Next are sunglasses and spectacles. So definitely, yeah. So I'm pretty sure you'll be carrying shades along with you, but do make sure if you have glasses, you have numbers, do carry at least a pair of spectacles, because you might want to do that. It's pretty expensive. So one thing to note down is that this entire video is made for students, keeping in mind. So I'm talking about things which are expensive here. It's not that you don't get things around here. You get many things which you need, and even I would say you get many variety of materials or things here, but they are expensive, so that's why. A quick question here: have you already prepared your clothing packaging? If yes, how are you planning to tackle the cold weather here? Is there any special dress or attire that you want to recommend us that we should carry? Let me know in the comment section, please. Next, the electronics. Laptop, of course, for your studies, external hard drive for storage, spare phone and a charger, definitely, because you might want to carry one extra, because you maybe get robbed or you maybe lose your phone or it might get damaged. So it's better to have one spare phone along with the adapters, at least two, which I mentioned earlier, and a trimmer for your beard trimming, and portable power bank. Power bank is very much necessary. So we carry the power bank around everywhere, like literally everywhere in the city. A quick question, guys. Which gadget do you think is a must-have for a student who is traveling abroad? Well, I would say it's a power bank. Yeah. What are your recommendations? Toiletries and personal care. So first is toothbrush and toothpaste, a pretty small one. Shampoo and conditioner, soap and body wash. Definitely you'll get it here, but again, it's expensive. You will get much better quality here, but I don't think so. As a student, it's a priority to get high quality cosmetics, so get it from your home country. Razors and shaving creams, deodorant and sunscreen is a must, because you will definitely need it in summers. It's pretty harsh. In fact, if I talk about me, all these years I've hardly used any sunscreen back in India, but after coming here, I think it's a need that you should use sunscreen, otherwise you get tanned badly. Next is and feminine hygiene products, some of which I use is the epilator. So I don't go to a parlor for my eyebrows or my waxing, so instead I use epilator and eyebrow razors. So that's something you might want to carry, along with some vitamin C serums and all those acids, salicylic acid, and I'm sorry if I'm spelling it wrong, but all those skincare serums you might want to bring, because here it's expensive. And moisturizer, henna, hair color. You need one notebook and a pen, because getting a notebook here that is unrolled or a rolled one is difficult, because people here use box ruled notebooks, which you see kindergarten kids use in our country, right, to write their maths subject. So those sort of notes are available here mostly, so it's difficult to find just simply ruled books. And Ujala bottle, because you see, this is my white cloth which is turning milky white or maybe brown in summer days, so you will not find Ujala bottle. Carry at least a small one. And lastly, a weighing machine, which will cost you around 700 rupees on Amazon. Yeah, because you keep changing the weights, adjusting it, and once you're here, you will be traveling to other countries, so even they have some sort of restriction at the airport, so you will end up weighing your suitcase multiple times. Did I miss out any in my toiletry kits list? I don't know. what is that one personal hygiene item that you might want to bring here or you cannot live without? Let me know in the comment. The very last segment, the heart and soul of every Indian, the kitchen items. Firstly, cooking utensils. Definitely carry a cooker of at least 3 liters. Masala box or masala dabba, as I call it. Lunch box, at least 1 or 2. A small storage container. This is optional, but it's up to you. Next, groceries, which will last at least for 1 week, because you will take some time to figure things around once you're here. Next are the spices and the condiments, but very limited, guys, because if you have seen my previous videos, I had already made some videos on the stores that are here. So all the masalas, all the items which are in our grocery list are available over here. But yes, it is little expensive, but it's manageable. So don't carry more grocery items. Tea filter, or what we call it as channi. So you do get here in different size and shapes, but it's not really comfortable to use it as a channi. So just carry one channi. And Maggi masala. So it's universal. It blends with every other food that is there, right? So carry maybe 2 or 3 packs of masala, which might last you for 2.5-3 months. You do get Maggi masala here, but it is for the chicken items or the meat items. So that the taste of that doesn't really go well with vegetarian food. So okay, so that was about the kitchen items. And what's your spice that you would definitely want to carry from India? You can just suggest, or something which any food item is incomplete. So which is that spice item that you think it is? Let me know in the comment. Oh, one important thing that we missed about packaging your food items. So I will add a reference picture showing how we pack. So what you can do is put it in a Ziploc pouch and then name it, be it whether chili powder or mustard seeds or a turmeric powder. Name it, because it becomes easy when you put it in the scanner. They can read it and they might not want to open it and check it out what seeds they are. Usually seeds are not allowed for you to carry from one country to another country, so keeping that in mind, this is safer. Finally, summarizing everything, I have few notes that I definitely want to share with you, because I learned all of these in a hard way and I want to share it with you so that you don't do the same mistakes which we did. So here are those 10. First one, pack all your original documents along with one photocopy and a soft copy on your cloud or a drive. Almost every Indian grocery items are available here, so you don't want to buy a lot of bulk items, grocery items in your backpack. No need of chakla, belan, pans or even cutleries. Trust me, chakla, belan and pans are available here at a medium rate. It's not even expensive. I'll tell you which way to buy them as well in the next section. Also, keep an eye on summer and winter sales. So this is when you might want to buy a lot of clothes or all these items, because they are at a heavy discount, right? And next is, and like I said earlier, there is no need of Forex card. So you will be pretty much fine even by using your debit or a credit card, which you have been using back in Europe, India. So that's one. And Primark is really economical. So once you're here, if you are short of any clothes or any items, you can buy it from Primark. And also Action. It's spelled as Action. Otherwise, we say it as Action. So it's for home decors and kitchen items and much more. You should visit that store once, so it will give you a rough idea of what are the things that is available. Oh, and also about belan and chakla, that is where it is available at a very low price, around 3 or 4 euros around ish. Yeah. And there is one online Chinese e-commerce platform called Temu, T-E-M-U, where all the items, you just name it from any department or section, they are available at a very cheap price, be it home decor, plants, clothes, kitchen items, electronics, everything is available over there, and you have a wide range of varieties. So if you have any need, you can buy it from there. But just one thing to note, it takes around 8 to 11 days to get it delivered to your doorsteps, so you keep in mind of the delivery time. And use vacuum bags to optimize your packing. This really saves a lot of space in your trolley, so you will be able to carry much more content if you use the vacuum bags, which I'll link here. And lastly, if you happen to exceed, which is what eventually gonna happen, because we did exceed around 17 kilos of our luggage, so as a student we did ask for waiver at the reception and they agreed, right? So just tell them that you're a student and you request for a waiver. So if you're lucky, you might get the price waived. Right, so that's about all the notes. Got any items that you're unsure about bringing here? Drop a comment below and I'll help you figure it out. Finally, the takeaway from this entire video is that, guys, prioritize your personal items such as chili powder or the turmeric powder, which has been prepared by your mom, or some masala, magic masala, like, or homemade masala. Prioritize that, but other than that, everything is available here. And along with warm clothes, do take the weather literally seriously, right? Some of my friends last time did not carry warm clothes and they ended up buying expensive items here, which they regretted later. So don't do that mistake. And lastly, the basic medications, which I mentioned earlier, you definitely require it, because of the change of climatic condition and the altitude, you'll definitely are prone to fall ill initially 90% of the time. So carry the basic medications. To make your journey smoother, I've compiled an entire list into a detailed guide packed with extra tips for traveling abroad. Don't miss out. Download it now using the link below in the description. Your adventure starts here, so grab it and get prepared. Alright guys, I hope this video was helpful to you and it was informative. So in case if you have any questions, feel free to book one-on-one call with me. The link is here in the description. Book it at your availability and your convenience. And to all those people who are leaving their country and traveling abroad for their studies, I really commend you guys. This is not a simple step that you have taken. Leaving your comfort zone, moving to other cities with just carrying one or two backpacks, packing your whole world in those bags, it's just so overwhelming, and I can't even imagine it, because that's something which I did as well. So all the very best to you, and I'm definitely sure you'll be doing great in going years. So see you in the next video. Until then, bye bye. We'll be right back.